I've decided that one of my next videos is going to be a Q&A, because they're easy and I've never done one before. So before we start this week's presentation, I invite you to ask anything you would like to know in the comments below. Now you can ask anything ranging from the 76 to the Troopy, or stuff about my workshop machinery, or why do you still feel guilty about your parents' divorce, or is it still gay if you don't push back? Tonight, a dead cat gets a haircut. I'm finally able to lift my wallet. And lots of stuff gets pointed at. It's time. It's reached that point in time when we're finally going to find out what's happening with this little ram thing. And here it is. I'm going to use it to very slowly open the rear door. Now it doesn't open or close the door fully, but unfortunately this is something I'm just going to have to deal with. Not really. I'm going to use the ram to turn my bedroom into a kitchen at the push of a button. Now there are a few ways I can do this. I could take out this plank and replace it with a table. I could make the bed lift directly upwards, but that would make getting in a bit of a contortionist exercise. Or I could do my usual and make something over complex to do almost the same job and add a lot of extra effort for minimum advantage. I have chosen this option. To the computer. So most of the things that I make that involve more precision than hitting two rocks together are made using CAD. That's cardboard-aided design. I'm not sure why every single channel that contains any kind of fabrication uses this pun. It makes my wife scream and my children cry. Anyway, CAD means computer-aided design. And you can use it to make stuff digitally, as well as test stuff without having to make a load of scrap metal failed prototypes in the process. It's also a great way to visualize stuff. This doohickey is going to turn my bed into a table at the push of a button. It's been designed around the ram's shortest and longest lengths, meaning that it should turn off automatically at both the top and bottom without tearing itself apart. Bold claims, right? So let's figure out how to use computers to turn digital stuff into real stuff. Now it's quite simple really. In this case, I want to make this little tab here. So if I open it, there it is. And now it's just a simple case of reaching in and grabbing it. Now unfortunately this only works on the smaller parts because some of them are bigger than the screen, so you have to do this in other ways. Introducing CAM. To summarize the next part, all we're doing is converting CAD into CAM and pressing the Go button. But this is how it works. Now this CAD software doesn't speak the same language as my CNC plasma cutter. The CAD software speaks I know how it looks language. And the plasma cutter speaks I know how to copy that and make it language. So in order to make something, you need somewhat of a Google Translate to help the machine and computer talk to each other. It gets worse. You need two of them. The first part converts the I know how it looks language into a series of instructions. This then needs to be converted into instructions specific to your machine, because unfortunately, they're all a tiny bit different. The last step is called post-processing. This is where a lot of expensive mistakes can happen. Hopefully that won't happen today. This is where you set all your parameters like backlash, speeds and feeds, and all sorts of other stuff. But if you get it wrong, then you need a mortgage. Anyway, if you're into this sort of thing, get a copy of Fusion 360. It's free if you're not using it for commercial use, and it combines the first two steps very well. However, as I'm a bit awkward, I use a slightly more versatile standalone CAD package. But Fusion is a good one-stop shop for people playing at home. But all it means is that I have to do an extra step to convert my files into Fusion files. Anyway, once you've got your CAD, you can make your instructions. Then we're just about ready to feed it into the post-processor and press the go button, where lots of fire and molten metal happens. Sounds good, right? Have a montage. Anyway, for more about this machine, check out this video. You might notice something. It doesn't seem to fit together right now. And to solve this, I've bought some bits. Typically, you'd mount these bearings like this. But what this does is put an excessive bending moment on the bearing when it's not supported at the other side. So I've decided to use them wrong and mount the bearing inside the metal so that the force is transmitted with a minimal bending moment on the bolt. So I've got some welding and bolting to do. Have yet another montage. So this is it, my weird pivoting platform thing. But how can it pivot using only an electronic RAM that can only move in and out? Well, prepare yourselves for the most effort I've ever put into any video stuff with the magic of overlaying. So the bed slash table is going to be bolted on here. The other end will be bolted onto the car. And as we know, the RAM pushes in this direction. And as you can see, the RAM isn't pushing perfectly horizontally, meaning it has both a normal and a tangential force. In turn, this pushes in two directions at the same time on the arms, and creates a moment around these bearings. Now, because the parts are quite strong, they don't distort, and the reaction forces are taken up by the bearings, as they're the path of least resistance. This arm is in tension, while the other's in compression, because of the table acting on the structure. And when all these things combine, the result is, as the RAM extends, everything pivots, lifts up, moves backwards, and as the arms are all equal lengths, the top platform stays completely level. In theory. Now that was probably a very garbled explanation, so if you're interested in things explained better, type engineering mechanics into Google. So as this definitely got assembled first time without any issues at all, it's time to test it. Now as you can see, it works outside of the car. And as you can also see, it needs some improvement. And what I'm going to do is reinforce these arms so there's no flex in them, as well as adding a pivot point for the RAM that isn't an Allen key. Now with the joys of video editing, this can all happen when I clap my hands. So now that that's all fitted, all that's left to do is push the button and see what happens. We've run out of time. You'll have to find out in the next episode.